some reading the Bible studies.
And the week before then.
It was about how many angels we have in the Bible.
Angels.
That was the last.
I like studying the Bible, because if you know the word of God, Satan can never cheat you. Some people sleep and they open their Bible, they put it beside them.
Under their pillow.
They sleep. Or under their pillow. Does it give you protection, actually?
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Does the Bible give protection?
No.
All those who are saying it gives protection, raise my hands.
Mine is sometimes.
Sometimes it protects you, the Bible. Let me ask this question. Is this the Bible, right?
Yeah.
Is it the word of God? Say yes or no. Is
yes.
it the word of God?
Yes.
Is it the word of God?
Yes.
All of you are saying yes.
No.
Is the word, is the Bible the word of God?
Yes.
It's the word of God.
Those who are saying no, raise your hands up, please.
How?
If it's not the word of God. Okay, it's only my wife who says it's not the word of God. Because she knows the answer is correct. It's not the word of God. Yeah, what are you saying? But it's a Bible. Yeah. You know what? The word of God is not paper and ink. Really? Show me your Bibles. You have your phone, don't pick it up. It's off your phone, off it. When you go home, you continue the chat. Lift up. Okay. I'm asking a simple question here. Somebody came to Eve and said, did God say you should not eat from this tree and this fruit? Who was that?
Satan.
Who was it?
Serpent. The Satan. Satan.
Lucifer. Snake.
Lucifer, snake, Satan.
The devil.
The devil. Okay. Somebody came to Eve and said, did God really say you should eat from this fruit or this tree? Who was speaking?
The devil.
So if we say Satan, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Who was speaking? Satan, right? Good. Is it written here?
Yeah.
Yes. It is the paraphrase there. And who said, if you are the Son of God, take this stone, cut into bread and eat it?
The same Satan.
Satan. Who said, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, because it is written that he will cause his angels to take charge of it. Who was speaking?
Satan.
Is it written here?
Yes.
So, is it the word of God?
It's a word of God.
Okay, let me tell you the thing. This book contains the word of God. It contains the word of God. So you don't have to open it, put it on your side, and sleep. But what is written here cannot jump up and fight Satan, because his word is also in it.
You have to speak.
He speaks. And sometimes when Paul writes letters to the Romans, the Corinthians, he said, I speak, not the Lord, but I. He specified for you to know that he is a man speaking. So man, word is also in it. So the question again. Is it the word of God?
It contains the word of God.
So you are learning. Every day we learn, right?
Yeah.
Good one. Now, last week we went to convention. What type of convention did we go? Was it an Easter convention or a Christmas convention?
Christmas.
So Christians, we celebrate Christmas, right?
Yeah.
Good. So let's learn about Christmas. How did Christmas come out about? Who brought about it? When did it start? Okay. See, I'm going to ask a question, so she starts hiding the face. All right. In which part of the Bible is Christmas written?
Matthew.
Christmas. Hey, you don't read the Bible, eh? Okay. The reason why I started the first question was that you don't have to open the Bible and lay by your side while you're blue and sleep. No. By learning it in your heart. When Satan attacks you, he attacks you from inside. When you get inside and the word of God is there, he runs away. You stay far away from him. Some people have the Bible like Lego students in Ghana. Like that. But when you ask them to open your office, they don't even know where it is. But they have the Bible, then Satan always slaps them all the time. But those who learn it, David said, "Your word have I hidden where? In my heart, that I may not sin against you." So it's up to you to learn the Bible or learn the word of God. It will help you to grow. Yes? Now, Christmas started in Genesis. Who believes that? All the way in Genesis. That's where Christmas started. I'm going to draw a picture for you so that you can understand the Christmas you celebrate. Yes? And you can also know how deep the love of God for you is. Because if you know how deep God's love for you is, you'll not come to church as if you are doing God a favor. You come to church with revival, with zeal, with determination. Even when the time for you to come to church, you watch your time and say, I'm about to eat. No. You leave the food and just run. Why? Because you know the person you are going to. You know the God you are going to. You'll be your number one. But because we don't understand certain things, we take things literal anyhow. But I pray that from today, your eye will open.
Amen.
I like teaching. Well, that's one of my gifts. And I explain things to you, then you understand it much better. Yes? If you have a Bible, go with me to Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. And the second person also open to Genesis chapter 3, verse 15. Are we there?
Genesis chapter 1, verse 26.
Big man. Sorry, where is your Bible? Yes. It's on your phone.
Digital.
Last time I thought I spoke to you about it, eh?
Yeah.
Okay. Get for me Genesis 3:15. Yeah, I like your Bible. Very nice one. I hope you read it.
It's okay.
And it's good. The bigger, the better. I like big things. Okay, let's go, please. Genesis 1:26.
Chapter 1, verse 20.
Open your Bible and then read with her whilst Brother
James
opens Genesis 3:15. Let's go, please.
Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. I'm reading from the NIV version. Then God said, "Let us make man in our own in our image, in our kindness, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and the bird of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground." Amen.
Amen. And God said, "Let us make man in our own image." I'm sorry, I'm no good with names, eh? Alex, was it?
James.
Genesis 2:16. 2:16.
Okay.
The first one on Genesis 1:26. The second one on Genesis 2. Please, wait a minute, I'm coming. We can take a seat for now. And God said, "Let us make man in our own
image."
And?
Likeness.
Image and likeness. What are the two words? I'm coming. And let them have what?
Dominion.
Pastor Bernard came here and spoke about it. Over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So, God created man in his own image. Let me ask you this question. Are you like God?
Yeah.
Show my hands. Yes, you are like God. Yeah. He made you in his own image.
God doesn't sin.
I'm not talking about sin. Just as you are, Friday you were here, you and I, we did a powerful job. It was, you see, you miss it. You see, she missed it. Tell her you are missing it. If you are here, you know that you are like Jesus. Do you know that you are like Jesus? What's your name?
Ophelia.
Ophelia, do you know you are like Jesus? Then why are you saying you are not like God? Okay, I won't go there because you missed Friday, so I won't go back there. And God said, let us make man in our own image. Let them have dominion. The word dominion means kingship rule, power, authority over everything on earth. God did not say, let us have dominion. If he said, let us have dominion, it means he is part of the rulership on earth. But he gave the dominion to who?
Everyone.
Man. On where? On earth. That's why anything that happens on earth, God wants you to deal with it. It's like your parents giving you a room in your, in the house. If you like, put your bed here. If you like, put your TV there. It's up to you. Amen?
Amen.
Now, this word dominion that God gave us is what is causing you and my problem. Because you couldn't hold it well. Amen.
Amen.
We are coming to Christmas. Eh? That's where Christmas started from. Good. And because we were the legal representative of God on earth, we have every power to decide who come here on earth and who does not. Remember, God said over everything that creeps on the surface of the earth, including the snake. So here comes Satan, Genesis 2:16. Genesis 2:16, God said, God commanded the man to eat everything in the garden, except so, the commandment was issued to eat everything, except one. Please read them for us. We come to Christmas very soon. Genesis 2:16.
Okay, I'm reading from Genesis 2:16. And the Lord God commanded the man, you are free to eat from any tree.
You are free to do what?
Eat any fruit.
Okay, hold on. Do you eat?
Yes.
Akosha, do you eat?
Yes.
Akosha, why do you eat? You are Akosha at all?
Yes.
Oh, and I say yes, it's a fancy name for Akosha.
Yeah, I know.
How did I know you are Akosha? You look
that
like
I was asking my sister.
Akosha, do you eat?
Yes.
Good. Sister Ophelia. Oh, Miss Ophelia, right? Ophelia, do you eat?
Yes.
Sister Gifty, my sister, do you eat? What do we eat?
To grow.
To grow, uh-huh.
For energy.
For energy, uh-huh.
For vitality.
For health. Okay. What do we eat, Mama? What do we eat to work? We don't eat to grow. We don't eat to be healthy. And you just read it. Because it's a command. And the Lord God commanded the man to do what?
To eat.
So each is a command.
It's a command.
Do we pray?
Yes.
I like this class. Do you pray?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you always pray loudly or sometimes inwardly?
Inwardly. Sometimes. Mostly inwardly.
It depends
the area where you are.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Why do we pray?
Because we are commanded to.
We pray because of Genesis 1:26. We have the dominion power.
Yeah.
But the moment you pray, last time I talked to you here that when you pray, you are giving God the permission to do something on earth.
Yeah.
You understand? It's like when you are in your own room and your parents knock at the door.
Yeah.
It's up to you to open.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. God, we continue. So please continue Genesis 2:16 for me. You need to be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
You need to look like AC. And God commanded the man, saying,
saying, you are free to eat from any tree in the garden. Second thing, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat of it, you will surely die. 18. The Lord God said,
it's okay, please. Thank you. And the Lord God said, he commanded the man, saying, of every tree of this garden, you may freely eat. Pawpaw, guava, everything, freely eat. But of the tree of
good and evil.
What did you just say?
Good and evil.
No. There's one word there.
Knowledge.
Yeah. Knowledge. That word knowledge is very important. Don't skip it.
Yeah.
But the tree of the knowledge of good and evil shall you not eat. Because why? Because
you will die.
Nay. Read your Bible. It's there. Check this. Don't skip words in the Bible. Every single word is important. Because in the day, say day.
Day.
Christmas day. Easter day. Sun day. Man day. To day. Don't skip words. Because in the day that you eat of the fruit, you will do what?
You will die.
Good. So, when did Adam die? In the day he ate the fruit. It's very important. So the day you don't come to church,
the day you die.
You know that, but you miss a lot. So, the Lord God commanded him, he said, don't eat of anything. Don't eat of everything except this. But Adam, one way or the other, missed the mark. And then he ate the fruit. Has anybody told you which kind of fruit did Adam eat?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They said it was apple.
Okay. I won't go there now. Next time I will tell you the hidden secret inside this verse. Because we don't know the fruit he ate, we all eat the same fruit every day. For example, I came here, or Jeffrey came here as first. When he came, he saw cookies here with tea there. He picked the cookie and the tea and he ate. And he started having cramps in the stomach. And Jeff didn't tell me. When I come and I saw it, what do you think I'll do?
You also eat.
And when you come, I then tell you, what do we do?
You also eat.
Because nobody is telling us the fruit Adam ate, we are all eating the same fruit. You believe me that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that is not good. It's not good. So next time, I'll teach you the fruit he ate. And you'll be surprised. But not for today.
Maybe it will be our favorite.
Okay. So when the Lord God commanded Adam and Eve, or Adam not to eat this, Adam also passed over to the woman. The Lord God said we shouldn't eat this fruit of the knowledge of good and evil. But here comes Satan. He went through the body of the serpent, and the serpent came to the woman. And then the Bible says he beguiled the woman and tricked her as she ate of the fruit. But when Eve ate the fruit, nothing happened. But when Adam ate the fruit, something happened. The Bible said their eyes were what?
Open.
What kind of eye open is this? I won't go there.
Tell you the knowledge
for next time. I'm just giving you some scratch surface for the Christmas, yeah? So, God had already said, the day you eat this fruit, you will do what?
You will die.
He used a word there before the die. You will
surely.
That means I make sure.
I mean it.
I mean it. I promise myself you will die. Who created death?
God.
Good. Death was created, but death did not have life. So death was created dead. Who knows what a bottle is? Flesh. Can a bottle cut you?
No.
No.
When does a bottle cut?
Unless you break it.
When it's broken, then it can cut. So death was there, like this balloon, but it had no power. So God said, the moment you eat that fruit, death will get power and then kill you. Amen.
Amen.
See how it is? So, did Adam have a choice here?
Yes.
Yes. Either to eat and die, or abstain from it and live. Simple. Let's come to you and I. Do we have choices?
Yes.
Yes. Do we sometimes make the right choices?
No.
We made the wrong choice, we hit and say, shit. But the choice we make is not a choice of life and death, like the one of Adam. When we make wrong choices, we can always go back, make things right. But Adam had only
option. One option, not two.
Either to eat or not to eat. And the result is life or death. So the Bible says in Romans that by one man sin. By one man what?
Sin.
Sin. They say by one man fruit?
Sin.
They say by one man eating?
No, sin.
So are you getting the picture behind the Genesis 2:16?
Yeah.
Say by one man sin, death enter where? This world. By one man sin, no. Did they say by one man eating? I don't go there. I'm just scratching the surface for Christmas. But when we went back to Genesis 1:26, the Bible says, God made man in his image. Now, do you know why God loves you? Do you know why God loves you?
Yeah.
Are you Isi? You are James. I want to speak to Isi today. Isi, do you know why God loves you? Do you know sometimes you do certain things, you deserve to be killed instantly. The day.
Yeah.
But God lets you live. Do you know why? Tell us.
Because? Because you have something for me for a purpose.
Okay.
Something like that.
Right there, please open Romans 5:12 for us. If you have a pen, write. I told last time that any time I come, write notes. For the lecturers, I'm listening to them. The moment they come to class, say, take notes. So I always take notes. So I'm passing over to you. Take notes. Romans 5:12. You see, I'm still listening. brother, please.
Enoch.
Enoch and sister Amma. I don't know your names. I'll try to know your names now. So if I ask you, don't be offended. Yeah? Mr. Amma, God loves you, right?
Yeah.
You know why God loves you? The same question I'm about to ask you, so think about it, your answer, right? You say God loves you. Why?
Because.
Do you have a child, please?
No.
No, okay. Nobody has here as a child? Okay, we thank God for now. Very soon you have your own case. But if you look at your child and you look at yourself, automatically you love your child. Why?
Because it's yours.
It's your
image.
It's your kindness.
It's your image.
Image.
It's your
image. Yeah. Next one, says, the man God said, let us make man in our image. God is invisible.
Yeah.
So for him to see himself, he made you. So that when he sees you, he sees himself. So God loves you because God loves himself. So God, when God is hurting you, he's hurting himself. Question two. Is God love?
Yeah.
Show my hands. Is God love? Show my hands. Is God love?
Yeah.
Fault.
He love.
Does God have love?
Yeah.
Oh, I missed a question. Does God have love?
Does God have love?
Yeah.
Is God love?
Yeah.
God is love.
Love, God is love.
He doesn't have, but he is love. So he loves you so much that he doesn't want anything bad to come to you.
Yeah.
But here we are in Genesis chapter 2, verse 16. He said, the day you eat this fruit, you will surely. And Adam did it. God said, I love man so much. Why do you break my heart? You give me heartbreak. Why do I love you so much? Then you won't do what I told you not to do. Romans 5:12. Are you there?
Yeah.
Please read for us.
I'm reading from Romans 5:12.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, just as sin entered the world through one man.
Hold on. Just as what entered?
Sin.
Did it say fruit?
No.
Let's go on.
And death through sin.
Mm-hmm.
And this way, death came to all men.
How did death come to this world?
Through sin.
Is it through Adam?
No.
Through who?
Sin.
Is it through the fruit?
No.
Through what?
Sin.
Continue. So I'm opening small, eh? Okay, let's go. You pray very soon, then we continue. But also from the beginning.
This way, death came to all men, because all sinned.
You see, to how many men did death come?
All.
Thank you. You were talking.
My mom was...
Uh-huh, continue.
For before the law was given, sin was in the world, but sin is not taken into account when there is no law.
Thank you. You can sit down, please. Thank you. You see, God is holy. When we say God is holy, He and His word are the same. His integrity, nobody can understand. So when God says something, He doesn't lie. That's why the Bible says, let all men be liars, and let God be what?
Truth.
So when He promised Adam, the day you eat this fruit, you will show that He meant it. So one way or the other, somebody got to die. But the Bible said, after Adam ate the fruit, how many years did he live further on earth? 930 years. After he ate the fruit.
No period.
But you say, but Elder, you said the day.
Mm-hmm.
Why? The day, the God said, the day you eat that fruit, hey, you will surely die. The Bible says he ate the fruit and lived 930 years longer. I mean, I have to eat the fruit. If I eat, I will live longer. No. The death here has two faces. The spiritual death and the physical death. Now, whenever you disobey God, or when Adam disobeyed God, there's God's spirit. Genesis 1:20 says, let us make man in our own image and likeness. God is a spirit. John 4:24, a time has come, and now it that the worshippers of God must worship in truth and in spirit, because God is what?
Spirit.
So for God to make man his image, God has to make man in a spirit form. So you are two in one. You are a spirit in a human body. So the moment Adam disobeyed God, the spirit of God left him. That time, he was dead. Many of us in churches are walking dead. You don't have God's spirit in them. You can see a nice gentleman in suit, not me. You have God's spirit in me, but he's dead. You can see an athlete on the field, running for a prize, he's dead. You can see the musicians on the stage, blasting and showing hands and doing things like that, they are dead. Why are they dead? Because they don't have
spirit
in them. They're dead. May God forbid that any one of us be dead in such a way.
Amen.
So God looked at Adam. For nearly 1,000 years, they were living with that girl. It's like you and your parents at home. There is no love between you. You are just walking in their sight anyhow. See, there's no
connection.
There's no feeling. You see, the atmosphere is not conducive. You're not feeling good. God looked at those things and said, "This is not good." Say, "It's not good."
It's not good.
So don't let God feel bad.
Yeah.
Anytime you do something wrong, you hurt the spirit of God that is in you.
Yeah.
And God said, I made you in my image. Mm-hmm. Don't do that. You see, everything starts right from the beginning. That's why we call Genesis the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
You understand to this point?
Yeah.
Any questions so far to this point? Before I move on. No questions? Sister Ophelia, you're going to read Genesis 3:15 for me, but before then, let me conclude this point. So God saw how things have been. Say yes. But remember, the Bible says everything that God made, it reproduces himself. Last time when I came here, I used a pear to demonstrate what is hidden inside the pear, right?
Yes.
Good. So if I took that pear seed and plant, what will I get?
Pear.
Another pear. Another pear. By the time you realize, the whole turnout is full of pear trees and fruit. That means it is producing after its own kind. Have you ever planted orange and produced mango before?
Mm-hmm.
No. That means every seed produced after its own kind. So, if Adam were to produce after his kind, what would Adam get?
His own kind.
Yeah.
I know his own kind, but
God?
Nay.
No. Adam.
Nay. Don't forget, oh. Don't forget. Genesis 1:26, God made us in his image. Genesis 2:16, he ate the fruit, so he died spiritually. And then if they got children after them, the children they got, they were
image.
They were without the spirit.
Image of who?
Adam.
So they were
sinners.
They were dead.
They were dead.
Yeah. Everything produces after its own kind. So if Adam is dead,
children.
The children are
dead.
Abel was dead, Cain was dead, Seth was dead, all of them were dead. So people who don't believe Jesus Christ, who don't have God's spirit inside them, when they have the baby is dead to God. That's why I said earlier on, most of us in churches are dressed but dead. Why? We are produced after the kindness of who? After dead. It was this that brought Christmas. Should I go in?
Mm-hmm.
Let me pause here for questions. I'm teaching. Feel free to ask me anything about this. Otherwise, I'll ask you. Amma, what's your name, Tom?
Yeah.
Amma, any question? Genesis 3:15. Amma, I'm listening. Your name, please?
It's Arnold.
Arnold. Yeah. You have any questions so far?
So I want to ask one question.
Okay, you can say.
When Adam did the fruit, where he said that he should not eat it, why did he see dead body size open?
Okay. Thank you. God said, the day you eat the fruit, you will die. But when he ate the fruit, his eye opened. The Bible said, and he died. His eye opened, right? Now. That's why I said, that's when I come, I'll go in more. That eye opening is like this. When you know your room, eh? Your bed is here, your TV is there. Even though when the light is not there, you can manage to go to your bed, right? But hit something per uncle with your feet. Shit. You go and do what? Press the light to show you much better, even though you think you know it. Now, that spiritual death he died caused their eye to open. God did not make Adam and Eve blind, though. They had eyes, they could see. But something else from outside came in that caused the eye opening in a different way. The eye opening is not this eye opening, but they got a knowledge.
Knowledge.
Nimdie. Nyansa. Omani te. Ni kechi kakrawa. Se kwasia e free. Kwa yim bakruma. And yadi anani bede yi. Hebe te. And yadi anani yati se. And yadi anani yati krumu ho pen niyama. Ni niya yadi ati. Wotu ni mufu. That's what it means. But what here class, you know, she used to wear long skirt. Mwa, a body tee, a shiny tissue, a good news you, Come on, come on. Come to Nabasa, say, rough, rough. You can't come here. But the moment she came to town, hey!
The city.
To city. Mm-hmm. She saw these girls on the high heel. Mm-hmm. Skirt here. Makeup's there. This one here, this one there. Nenyati.
I was lost.
And now he's working.
Majestically.
Majestically. Because she was... Now, brother, this working, is it a living working or a dead working? Dead working. Oh, they are her mugu away. She's dead. Meanwhile, when she was in the village, she used to cover herself up. Very respectable lady. Anyone would like to marry this one, this lady. But the moment she came to town, hey, the baby. She's showing everything, tight skirt and long, I mean, exposing half of your body. You are dead, she is dead. And the person in the near day. She get the knowledge of the city life. That's the answer to your question. Amos, Enoch, question?
God said when you eat the fruit, they come to the land. And you said the time in the spirit.
Yes.
So does that mean that they didn't have any relationship with God?
Thank you. Okay. You can sit down. Now, I'm coming to you. You're my best friend. I trust you so much that I talk to you every day about everything. And one day, the secret that I had, I say, Jeff, needs the club, eh? Niemand vertel, eh? You can ease it down. I told only you. Next 2 minutes is on WhatsApp. Everybody here. Jeff, and you see me, how do you feel?
Okay.
You'll be ashamed to come to me. You won't feel free. Yeah. Even though I have not asked you, you won't feel free. So God said, Adam, Adam, where are you? What was his response?
Nothing. I'm naked.
He said, when I heard your voice, I was afraid because I was
naked.
The same thing. Whenever you breach trust, forbidden is broken. That's what happened between Adam and Eve. They were dead. He said, I was afraid and I was naked. Mm-hmm. But what has where you are got to do with your silky dressing? Mm-hmm. The word he was naked doesn't mean he was not wearing anything. Mm-hmm. God left him in Genesis 1:26, dominion, mm-hmm. power, mm-hmm. king, ruler, master, manager, mm-hmm. over everything on the earth. Mm-hmm. But the moment he sinned, he fell mm-hmm. and lost that dominion. Mm-hmm. He has no more power, was powerless. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that word naked there, mm-hmm. powerless, you are nothing, somebody is now going to rule over you. Who has watched a movie from Cuba before? Cuba. South America, Cuba. Or any drug-related movies. They smoke this cigar.
Colombia,
Cuba, those South American countries. Cigar is made of a leaf. They smoke. And their lungs inside them, the thing that controls your breathing, that sieve the air we breathe. It gets kaput. Within 15 years, he's dead. Cocaine is from a leaf. Mm-hmm. Leaf. Somebody will hide, will be spouting themselves, they'll be homeless. Now, let me ask you this question. Who is ruling over who? Is it the leaf ruling over man, or the man ruling over leaf?
The leaf ruling over man.
But Genesis 1:26, God said, let them have dominion over what? And a common leaf is ruling one. Don't you see men are stupid?
Exactly.
It's good if you know Christ, eh? That's why I like it. It opens your understanding. The knowledge, when it be, when it take. For me, I've never done it before, and I will never go to the shop with my sweat, buy cigarettes, buy a lighter, and then pass and be smoking a leaf. So much so that I'll be addicted. That if I don't have it, I can't sleep. And the leaf, a common leaf, is ruling over me. Meanwhile, God said, I should have dominion over what?
All things.
That's why I said, and I'll keep on repeating. Without God's grace, we are dead. Thank God for Christmas.
Amen.
Christmas is an era or a time where you have to appreciate God so much. Because without Christmas, it would be worse. No further questions? Should I continue? You like it like that? Okay. I continue.
And I think I
okay.
You see that Adam doesn't have chance to turn back, and God said that if he eats the fruit, he's going to die. And we, you see that we have chance to turn back when we sin. Now we can turn back. Is it all things that we do, we can turn back?
Yes, everything except one thing. Jesus said, every sin that a man commits, he shall be forgiven him. You can steal, God will forgive you. You can even insult your mother, God will forgive you, but your life is short. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Bible says, honor your parents in the Lord. But this is the only promise that has a reward attached to it, wrong life. So be careful how you treat your parents. God will still forgive you. But what sin is the one you commit, you will not forgive?
The Holy Spirit.
When you speak against the Holy Spirit, that one he will not. That one he will not. That's the only thing. So any sin you commit, you can go back and say, God, I've committed sin. But I thank you, you have already died for my sins. Father, forgive me.
He will.
Any sin. That doesn't mean, come and slap me and God will forgive me. He will punish you and he will forgive you later. Is that okay? Can I move on? You like it like that?
Yes.
Okay. Genesis chapter 3, verse 10 to 15. I'm reading here so that you can follow me. Take your Bibles. Every word there is important. Reading from verse 7. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves coverings. And they heard the sound of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord among the trees in the garden. Hey, does God have legs?
Yes, yes.
Hey, does God have legs?
Yeah,
yes.
No! No!
Hey. Yes, yes. Yeah.
Does God have legs? Of course not. God is a spirit. Does God have legs? No. Does God have legs?
Yes.
Yeah,
I think yes.
Yeah,
she said, make God like
a human being.
No, so we have not seen
him. I know, no one has seen him before. So.
We are the same in this.
We are the same.
Don't tell me that. Don't tell me that. Otherwise, I would point you to the. I just read something. Does God have legs? God is a spirit, though.
Yeah, I say he created man like his own image. When you see your friend, you see God.
So does God have legs?
Yes.
He said God was walking in the cool of the day. What do we use in walking?
Legs.
When you are reading the Bible, be careful, eh? God has legs, brother. What's your name? Give me a high five, echo. God has legs. Does God have hands?
Yes.
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 How do you see?
Because I have
his
image.
Because
I have
God
hands.
Because you have his image. Does God have one more to sit down?
Yes.
Yes.
Really? Is it written in the Bible?
No, because I'm his image.
Yeah, well. Yeah.
And God sits in his throne. He is one more to sit down. So, people picture God differently. Eh?
Yeah.
The fact that you have not seen God doesn't mean you can't know who he is. You get me right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So be careful how you treat me. I'm like God. I continue, right? Verse 9 says, then the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, where are you? Hey. Is this sentence correct? But the Bible says God knows all things. The Bible says God knows all things. But he's now asking, where are you? Is the sentence correct?
Yeah.
Because God doesn't have dominion over the earth.
Thank you. He has given the dominion to who? Adam. And Adam lost it. So the where are you doesn't mean where is your location? Where is your power? Where is your dominion? Where is your mastery? The Bible you are reading is contained deep things. It needs to be interpreted. The Old Testament was given in different language. Who wrote the Genesis book?
Moses.
Moses. When was Moses born? Oh.
A.D.
A.D. A.D. This is before Christ. Yeah. Adam was sorry. Moses was born in the book of Exodus. So everything that happened in Genesis, he wasn't there. But God communicated to him in a vision. And in vision, God used symbols, metaphors and literals. And he wrote them. But it needs to be interpreted. In Bibles to be called something hermeneutics. This is a science and art of interpreting the scriptures. That's what I'm doing now. We learn it. It is only in Bible schools. I'm not a pastor. I'm just lying. So next time when I come, I'll open more for you to see. Yeah?
Amen.
But today I'm scratching the surface. Christmas, bear in mind. So he said, I heard your voice in the garden.
Yeah.
That God has voice. Good. I was afraid. Because I was naked and I hate myself. God is asking, where are you? You are talking. Say, God, I am here. So that I chop the fruit, Father, forgive you. Instead of that, chat, chat. So some people, when they do something, you ask them. Instead of them to give you a direct answer, hey, chat, chat, chat. We call that circumlocution. Then you might worsen matters. Just go straight to the point. Ah, let's stop doing that. It was what's my cancer. So he said, who told you that you were naked? Who? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you that you should not eat? Which tree is that?
Knowledge.
The tree of knowledge of good and evil.
Thank you. You are following me. That's good. Then the man said, who is speaking here? Adam. Adam is a man. The Bible said, and the man said, that's why in the beginning I asked you, is this the word of God?
No.
It contains the word of God, because a man's word is in it.
Yeah.
So who is speaking here? Adam. He said, verse 12, the woman you gave me, she gave me to eat. He's putting blame on
wife.
Instead of me saying, Father, I know I have forgotten it. We're not pointing fingers.
Justified.
We're not pointing fingers. Oh, the room is too dirty. Elder, Mr. Philo was supposed to do it. Mr. Philo, you didn't clean it. Elder, Brother James lost the key to the uncle's house, and when he went to the uncle's house, stop pointing fingers. Tell him, stop pointing fingers.
Stop pointing fingers.
Then the man said, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave it to me, the tree, and I ate. And the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that you have done? The woman said, pointing finger. The serpent deceived me and I ate. See, you point fingers every day. It's not good, eh? Right from Genesis, that's where I was from. So the Lord God said to the serpent, the person who came last. Here's where Christmas was born. Listen carefully, eh? Who believed that Jesus Christ is in Genesis? But it's not mentioned here. Where is Jesus? I'm going to show you.
In the beginning.
Are you ready? What's there? God said, because you have done this, you are cursed than all the cattle, and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go. You shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I'll put enmity between you and the woman. Say woman.
Woman.
Man.
Man.
Woman.
Woman.
Man.
Woman.
Man.
Woman.
Woman. Yes, you're not saying it.
Woman.
Woman.
Man.
Man.
Let me pause. What is the difference between a woman and a man?
W-O.
I like it. God bless you. That's all. W-O. W-O is womb. Because we don't have womb. We can't carry children. And that womb, I'm coming. God specially designed the woman in such a way that the womb that she has is very powerful. Christmas is coming because of the womb. Listen. Listen. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. God is speaking to who?
Man.
Serpent. I'm reading verse. Open your Bible and read it with me. Verse 15. Verse 15, eh? We are there. Amos, where is your Bible? Did you bring it? You don't have? Do you go to school?
Yes.
When you go to school, do you leave your school bag at home?
No.
You take it to school, right? My wife comes and you forget. Yes, you think. Yeah. Are we there together?
Yeah.
Are we reading together?
Yeah.
Philomena.
Philomena, what's in
there? Let's read together. He said, I will put enmity between you, Satan, and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. Pause for a while. What is a seed? Last time when I came here, I demonstrated with the apple and the pear, the seed inside it. When I plant it, I get another pear of apple, right? So the seed will continue. You are all the seed of your parents. She is my seed. She will grow, get another one, get another one. By the time I realize I'm Opa. It's mere clanic. Alright?
Yeah.
But this God said, between your seed and her seed. That means Satan has seed.
Mm-hmm.
Satan has children.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that?
Mm-hmm.
Be careful you don't marry them.
Yeah.
I'm coming. I'm about to reach a point. And he shall bruise your head. And you shall bruise his heel. That word there, or that sentence there, is idiomatic expression.
Mm-hmm.
Let me explain it well, otherwise you will never understand. You will crush his head. That means the seed of the woman is going to crush whose head? Satan's head. And what is Satan going to do to the woman's seed? Bruise his heel. Now, what's the meaning of this? Head represents authority. Head is authority. That's why we have headmaster. He's authority of the whole school. Head pastor is the pastor of the whole church. The head represents authority, power, dominion. Who has it? Satan has it. Don't forget. Genesis 1 verse says God gave it to man. After they ate the food, they gave it to Satan. So Satan had authority now, that's the head. And when the seed crushes the head of Satan, Satan will bruise the heel. The heel is this. Those days when there were no scanning machines at the hospitals,
yeah.
They didn't have anything there. So when a child was born, for them to know that the child has life in it, they will hang the baby's head upside down.
Yes.
And here, behind your the friend said, intimisa, there's a vein here.
Yeah.
When we knife it, hold it like it, it's very painful.
Yeah.
Very, very painful. So when they turn the baby upside down and knife, it is knife.
Like,
what is knife in English?
Squeeze or
press. Squeeze or press or whatever.
Yeah.
And the baby cries, it means he has life. So the heel is a source of life. So Satan will crush Jesus' life, and that life he's crushing will take over the authority of Satan. So Jesus' death will cause Satan to lose his power. You understand it now?
Yeah.
So the heel of Jesus being broken, the life of Jesus being taken away, is going to demoralize Satan's power and authority. You understand it now? So the moment God said this, Christmas was born. That means the seed of a woman must come. A woman must be pregnant and work up for 9 good months. Uh-huh. So when that son is born or that seed is born, he is going to be killed. And that death, that is the heel being bruised, is going to cause Satan to lose his power. That's what we are having now. Satan has lost the power because of the work of the cross.
Amen.
We understand up to this point, eh?
Yeah.
Good one. Let's go back one step further. Backwards. Do women have seed or men have seed?
Men have seed.
Men have, women don't have seed.
Yeah.
Right now, you can never be pregnant on your own.
Yeah.
Unless you sleep with a woman, a man.
Yeah.
Good. Because I have the seed, I have to produce.
Yeah.
To my wife for us to produce beautiful kids. Yeah. Like that. But God said, the woman's seed. Does that make sense here? No. God had a plan in the mind. Come to Satan, Satan. When I was designing the woman, you were not there. I made it such a way that the womb, W-O, the womb inside is such a way that when there's a baby inside it, the womb, the baby's blood would never mix with the mother's blood. Never. If you like go to the hospital and ask the midwife and the doctor will tell you, the child's blood never mix with the woman's blood. Never. So God one day will come on this earth inside a woman's womb. That woman's blood is already sin, alright? But that sinful blood will never touch the baby. So the woman, the woman over there, very strong word. So when you read Galatians chapter 4 verse 4, the Bible says, in the fullness of time, God sent forth his son. Who is the name of the son?
Jesus Christ.
To come, and he was born under the law. To redeem those who were under the law. You understand it? So, whose birthday did we celebrate on Christmas?
Jesus.
When was he born?
Christmas.
Christmas Day. When was he born?
25th.
December. When was he born? When was he born?
In the fullness of time.
Day.
Day.
When was he born?
December.
In the AD.
When was he born?
Genesis.
Chapter 3, verse
15.
Your seed you bruised his head, and he will bruise your heel. The woman God speaks, he just was born there. Because we are waiting for that time. Okay, everything happened in the spirit, and it has to manifest in the physical. So when God said those things, it was in place.
Yeah.
Who is there by Galatians 4:4? Somebody read for me. You see, the Bible contains things that you always rush over, but you don't understand. If I'm not mistaken, I think it's Galatians 4:4. Very last name. Yeah, it's there. Who is there? Galatians 4:4.
Galatians chapter 4 verse 4.
Yeah.
But when the time had fully come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under law, to redeem those under law, that we might receive the full right of sons.
Thank you. It's good. Thank you. So you see now, when God came into the scene after they had eaten the fruit, God made a promise and said, you Satan, you think you have done it all? Done nothing yet. Nothing. The same woman that you tricked, the same woman that you deceived, the same woman that you. And he caused all these things to happen. I'm going to use that same woman to come back to you. Say, God is holy. Anything that God does, he does it for a purpose. Right? Don't forget that. You sitting here, you have a purpose. I talked about you last time when I came here, right? Good. So God prepared everything for something that's about to come. So, Isaiah said, for unto us a child will be born, unto us a son is given. Alright? Why did he say a child and a son? Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. It's like he's talking about two children here. No. The child is the body, the flesh. And the son is God's spirit inside of him. He will be born. And Galatians 4:4 says, when the fullness of time came. So God set a date on the calendar and he reversed it. And then he started playing it. So when the time of the calendar of God came, Mary had to deliver Jesus. And that's why we have Christmas. So let me go back to Genesis 2:16. When God said, the day you eat this food, you will surely die. They died, right? But God loved himself and loved me and you so much that he doesn't want to see us dying. But he is a God. Now when he speaks, he can't take back his word. Otherwise, you cannot trust him. If I say, I will drop you at the station when I finish church service, right? In the middle of church service, I had a phone call. Okay. Oh, sister, I'm supposed to have dropped you, but somebody, what's my father? I received you. No matter what the call is, I have a deal with you first. But that's how men is. That's how men are. You're like that. God isn't like that. No matter what happens, what he has said it. So, because he has said, the day you eat this food, you surely die, man must die. Or somebody got to die. Somebody got to die. So seeing himself or his image or his children dying is enough. Somebody must die. A death must take place. Death has been awoken. He's looking for somebody to kill. God said, you know, death is my word. I can't take it back because I'm God, I'm holy. Therefore, I will die. So in the fullness of time, Jesus Christ was born under the cross. So that all the things that me and you are doing, we have done, we are about to do, we're thinking of doing, now there are some things you have done. Last year, last month, yesterday, last week, it's gone. Even this morning, it's gone. There are some things right now, you are thinking, when I leave here, you are thinking of going to do. Even tomorrow has not come, but you are planning on the same you're going to do tomorrow. God knows it. He carried everything upon himself. He said, let me die. But spirits don't die, do they?
No.
So that means he needs a flesh. So he sent the angel to Mary and said, Mary, you are highly favored. The Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. You shall conceive and have a son. Galatians 4:4. And when that time came, Jesus was born.
Yeah.
So what was the importance of Jesus' birth?
To save mankind. To save mankind.
Because of us.
The answer is one piece, but you are breaking it into pieces. To do what?
To save life.
To save life.
He came for the sinners.
For the sinners?
Yeah.
You are not part of it. Okay, for the sinners.
To redeem those that have
come in. Hold on, he's basically going to do what?
To come and die.
To come and die. If it is to come and die, then why is that when Herod was killing children, he ran away? There is that. It's deep. Next time when I come, I'll go in. I'm scratching the surface for the Christmas. Jesus came so that the death penalty on man will be taken to himself. So that he will receive your death and you will receive his life. Anything wretched, he will take it and give you good. So the Christmas that we see is all about this. So if you understand this, your love for God will change. If you understand this, the how you see people celebrating Christmas, yours will change. For Christmas time, people have parties. They booze, they go to clubs and numero. But that's not why Jesus came for. He came to exchange your life for his. He came so that the nakedness that caused you to hide from God will be clothed again to be God.
Yeah.
That's why we are here this morning.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
You understand up to this point?
Yes.
Any questions so far? What time is it?
5:55.
Okay. we are about to close. I told you at 12. I like that you understand certain principles. From there, you can base your prayer life on it. From there, you can also teach your kids when they come. From there, you can talk to your friends at school. Even when, I can assure you that Amma, is your mom here?
Yeah.
When you go home, ask mom, when did Christmas even start? So for you to listen to this one, it's very, very important. Store it in your heart.
Amen.
So that when you grow, you teach your kids.
Amen.
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 Should I give two questions that we close?
No.
Amma was talking. Amma, why is it that during Christmas they put light on the streets everywhere? Lights, light, light. But the moment December is forby, they take all the lights out. Have you realized it?
Yeah.
All the shops, different lights.
Yeah.
Your kids boom in the house.
Yeah.
Light licked in, overall licked.
Yeah.
Why, Amma? We were talking, Amma. You gave me the answer. Amma, I'm hearing. I'm listening.
I know.
You know. You don't be talking to me. Enoch, why do they put lights everywhere?
Because they want everybody to see. Christmas. It's a Christmas time, so you have to
put. So Christmas time, they put light.
Yeah.
Why?
For sure.
And in January, everybody needs to go the lights off.
Because the light of the world has been born.
But the light of the world has been born.
Okay.
Thank you, partially. You wanna try again?
No.
You wanna try? Someone wanna try? Okay.
Because she says.
Okay, this is the light of the world. So let's put light on, light on, light on, light on.
Every day you have light in your house.
Every day you have light in your house. Okay. That light is a symbolism of knowledge. When there is light, do you stumble?
No.
No. So the light represents knowledge. The more you know God's word, the more your heart is enlightened to understand deep things of God. And nobody can deceive you or can cheat you.
Mm-hmm.
So the light represents knowledge.
Six times.
Any question to me? No question? You're about to be very close, yeah?
So, people like Abraham.
Yes.
People like very close to God. Okay.
Yes.
When Adam entered, he had spiritual. Why was Abraham like? Some of the people around me all seem very, very, very close to God like this. So people now, after the death of Christ, how they're close to God, but Abraham was really close to God before Jesus Christ came to die for us. So what was that with Abraham?
Okay. He asked, before Jesus came, very, can I continue? He asked, before Jesus came, Abraham was very close to God. Why was it like that? Okay, that was a question, right? Abraham's closeness to God was an act of one thing, and one thing only. Faith. Faith. Okay. If you believe me, you have faith in me, right? Okay. You are doing your things, you are happy.
Yeah.
Going to party and disco and jamming here and there, you're making money, you are happy. And I said all of a sudden, Jeff, leave everything. Come and follow me. Come. I'm going to give you a land for you and your children. Come. And you left everything behind. If you don't trust me, will you do that?
No.
If you don't believe me, will you do that?
No.
That belief, that faith that Abraham had, caused God to come closer to him. Closer to him. He didn't mean he didn't sin. He sinned. A point in time, he lied that, oh, this woman is my sister.
Yeah.
Oh, this woman is my beautiful sister. Meanwhile, she was a wife. He lied. He even slept with the housemaid to produce Ishmael. It was a sin. But still, God loved him because of one thing, faith, and belief. This one, when next time I come, I will tell you the fruit Adam and Eve ate. You understand this question better. Anytime you have faith and belief in God, He gets closer to you. That's why the Bible says, to them that believe, he gave them power to become the children of God. So belief is very, very strong way.
Yeah.
It was because of Adam and Abraham's faith and belief in God. That was why he was so close to God. Amen.
Amen.
If no further questions, we're going to pray and then we close. We pray, you get an offering, and then we close, right? Be on your feet, please.